Today we want to make a bridge on the upper jaw, a 12 unit, 12 crowns bridge on 7 multi-units, on 7 implants. And the biggest problem with this type of restorations is determining the height of the bridge and the occlusion, because in this case the patient doesn't have anything. You don't have any provisional bridges, you don't have any teeth, you don't know anything at all. On the lower jaw you have a temporal bridge on teeth. In a little bit later we'll change to zirconia bridge, but on the upper jaw we don't have anything at all. So we need to know what's going to be the height of the teeth, what the patient VDO, vertical dimension of occlusion, and we want to know where should be the central line and all the anatomical configurations of the bridge. So how we're doing it in our clinic. At first, we want to take impressions of the upper jaw. When we take impressions, I mean we place on top of the multi-unit scan abutments, and we scan all those scan abutments, and we scan all the palatal area. When you restoring an upper jaw, it's much simpler because you have an attached gingiva. The attached gingiva is not, almost not movable, so you can just scan it, and the scanner will have a quite good accuracy.
Because it's not moving?
Yeah, nothing is moving.
So if you had the same case, but let's reverse it, it would be much tougher if
yeah.
it was on the lower jaw. Because of the tongue?
By a lot.
Because of the tongue and all the fluids?
The tongue, the small amount of gingiva that you have, the cheeks, everything that's moving all around those implants. So when it's the upper jaw, it's much simpler. But still, you don't have, right now you have the orientation of each implant, and you know where are the implants in relation one to another. You don't know any relations between the upper and the lower jaw. So we took impressions and we took all the palatal area, and right now we want to make some sort of composite bulk to, and with this composite we want to let's say fix the VDO, the vertical dimension, and on this bulk we can like paint the central line and the occlusion.
So using this method you will get the VDO in the fastest way possible. Just add the composite,
yeah,
you cure it, and that's it.
You started adding composite one layer on top of the another until you can see that with the lips and the cheeks you have enough you have enough height, and everything is done in occlusion, so the patient can open and close his mouth and get back to the same place. It's not like when you're doing it with a wax and you have very thick layer of wax. In here you can see the how the lips gonna look like after the restoration. You can add a little bit in the buccal part, you can remove a little bit in the buccal part. So you know how the bridge and the lips and everything will synchronize. You can see in this video that when the patient opens and closes her mouth, the teeth get back to exactly the same place. First of all, the composite is hard material. It's not like wax. If she'll close a little bit stronger than her teeth, she won't deform the composite. And on the other hand, she can open and close and get back to the same spot exactly as we built this composite material. So with this composite material, we know the exact VDO that we chose. And because we built this composite material only in the frontal area, all the palatal area and all the distal scan abutments, we can see them. And then we can place this scan of this composite material with the palate and the scan abutments on top of the previous scan that we took. And we'll have all of the jaw with all of the scan abutments, with all the palate, with everything. And it will be in relation to the lower jaw. according to what we built with the composite material.
Thank God for composite.
Yeah, thank God for composite.
So this is the temporary bridge already mounted with the, all the contact points.
In most interesting, I think the amazing part that you can see is you have contact points in all of the places. So you know that when the patient closes her mouth, you have pretty good occlusion. Maybe you can achieve a little bit better. Maybe you can have, this is without touching anything at all. She closes and both sides in occlusion. You need to correct a little bit the occlusion, but it's you're not starting with nothing.
It shows how effective this method is.
Many times when you take with impressions the occlusal relations, you get something like not parallel even. You have contact only on one side and not the other.
That much of a deviation?
Yeah, you can have a huge amount of deviation.
It's better than to do it by eye.
And in here you can see that you get something pretty good in the first place. Maybe you need another version, maybe you need to correct it a little bit, but the first result is quite good already. We got central line in exactly the same place that we wanted. We have the anatomy of the teeth that good enough for us, or right now we can, if the patient have problems, we can change it a little bit. We can add or remove material. We can move the teeth into the buccal or make the teeth a little bit smaller. Depends on the patient wishes and what we see in the mouth, because in the computer you don't see always the same thing. We played with the anatomy a little bit, so every time we changed it. And when you mill in the bridge or print in the bridge, the provisional bridge, you already have this design in the computer. So the final version that you want to make and that you see in the mouth, that the design, that the anatomy is good, you can mill it from zirconia. You can already send it to manufacturing and get the same design as was the provisional bridge. It's, for example, a problem with the PFM. Because you have a metal carcass and the technician adding ceramics on top of the metal. So you won't get every time the same thing exactly. You have each time a little bit different anatomy. So this was probably the final version of teeth. You can see that we made the teeth a little bit look a little bit higher. This one even a little bit wider. You can see that this multi-unit is visible because it's an angulated multi-unit. And with angulated multi-units, in many cases, you have a buccal bulge. So in the buccal part of the multi-unit, you will see it, it will be visible, but it's very, very high. And it's much higher than her smile line. So you won't see it when she smiles.
This is another version, or it's the same?
Yeah, maybe it's the same version. We made a lot of versions because each time the patient had some complaint and we wanted to show her what we can do and what we can achieve. Up until the final version that we made from zirconia, we cemented sleeves. We in between the teeth, we add a little bit of color to see better the separations, and we changed the lower bridge also to zirconia, so you can see.
So the central line is really in the middle.
Yeah, the central line in the middle, and you can see that the central line of the lower bridge is probably a little bit shifted because it's on her own teeth, and it's a little bit of a problem to move it to the right of the patient. And you can see that when she smiles, it's very symmetric and it's parallel to her smile. And everything was done. The only thing that we changed, we had only one impression. The only thing that we changed every time is a little bit the design. But the first impression that we took with the first relations between the jaws and the vertical dimension, we could define it using this composite material in the first place, and we did it only once. You don't need to redo it.
You just fix the bridge bit by bit in the temporal bridges.
Adjusted the anatomy.
Mm-hmm.
What you see in the computer when you design the bridge is not what you'll see in the mouth. It's very hard, even using the most advanced programs with smile design and face 3D scanners. It's still very difficult to do it from the first time, from the first temporal bridge. You need to have some revisions.
Thank you very much for being with us today.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being with us today. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and follow to stay tuned up to date. Thank you and see you next time.